The Sahara is best reached from the north through Morocco. In from the coast on the desert's edge is the exotic city of Fez, a strange and fascinating sun-scorched town. Its white terraced roofs, like those of ancient Babylon. Its gates and buildings following the designs of old Egypt, peopled with a motley group of races and tribes, an intermingling of strange customs and ancient creeds. On entering the town through one of its many gates, we find the streets narrow to keep out the scorching sun as the people work and play. Life here is never dull, for from out the desert, caravans constantly come and go. The people watch the fun as the horsemen ride wild on fine Arabian steeds. From the tower of the mosque, the priest calls the white-robed worshippers of Islam to prayer. And throughout the town, the devout salam at the sacred hour. Allah! Allah! Market days are important occasions. Camel caravans bring many things. Much changes hands. Meats and sheep, fruits and vegetables, and trinkets for the dancing girls. Native craftsmen with primitive methods as old as man create the things the people need and give expression to their arts. The tribesmen find relief from the infinite monotony of the desert. Primitive tom-toms and high-pitched flutes in a wild cadence start a ritual dance. It gets in the blood of the town people, too, and they, as well as the dancers, respond to the barbaric rhythm of strange tunes. The marketplace is always interesting. The fakers are busy entertaining with acts that astound and defy understanding. Mystifying tricks that have startled spectators for generations. All gather in this square to watch and wonder at the amazing feats of these men. The local life goes on just the same. The women do most of the heavy work. The men ride the desert sands and fight to keep off the nomad tribes that live beyond the city. When the market days are over and the feast is done, the provision caravans start off again. To the south lies the limitless desert Sahara, a vast ocean of hot sand, as restless and changing as the sea. And once again, the long trek across the golden glittering sands in the gasping heat and blazing sun. The drivers know every mile of the established caravan routes, for to be lost in the desert is an awful end. Water is precious in this land of thirst and heat, and wherever found, there is a sacred haven. The women fill their jugs and carry them to the men and camels, enough to last until the next oasis is reached, deep in the desert, maybe days hence. The journeys are from oasis to oasis as the caravans move along. There is need for the relief of shade and water, water for man and beast. And over the burning sands, the camels move. They never seem to tire, and no matter how heavy the load, they do not complain. For centuries, they have been the desert man's best friend. 130 degrees in the sun, there is no shade. The hot sands give birth to wild desert winds. The camels sense it first as the early currents throw up little eddies of top sand. A breeze sways the palm. The riders hurry on, hoping to reach the walls of a desert village before the might of the storm strikes. The winds sweep in, rapidly increasing in violence. Like ships at sea, the caravans often must ride out the storm. The storm is at its height, swirling, cutting, blinding sand. But the winds subside, the hot sun shines again, and the wide horizons quiver in a wave of scorching heat. In French North Africa, the Foreign Legion is a tradition. The officers and the men are among the finest soldiers in the world. The wild wandering tribes, the brigands of the desert, must be kept under control, and the caravans and towns protected from raids. In scorching sun and blinding storms, they ride when duty calls. These brave riders police a world of sand. Their far-flung outposts dot the wide expanse. Day's work done, they return to barracks. Tomorrow, they will ride again. Through the ages, adventurous men and their faithful camels have traveled the endless desert. And in the future, they still will move across the burning sands of the great Sahara.